HD, please.
Hey.
And this is a double.
Good to see you.
See you guys.
How did you get a double?
What's up? I get a double because I do this for all the other people who we don't let come talk to you. Wow, that's so fast. All right, so what is it you guys think about this book and this movie series that has become such a cultural phenomenon?
I think that it basically kind of has something for everyone, this saga. And if you don't get it in one film, you'll get it in the next. But there's so many universal themes in this story. And you've got, you know, you've got love, you have loss, you have revenge. You have some really important decisions that you see Bella have to go through. You see people coming together with archenemies to, you know, kind of come together for the better good of our family. So I think that, you know, there's a little something for everybody here.
What about your thoughts, Colin?
I mean, Ashley hit the nail on the head. It's really cool, and especially for me, coming from a big family. I have a sister who, you know, is getting into the high school kind of issues with life. You have a lot of decisions from boyfriends to schools to choosing a college major and stuff like that. And it's really interesting to see how she's developed into a bright woman from reading these books and knowing that you don't have to be peer pressured into situations. You can wait with your boyfriend and, you know, take things slow and learn who they are and learn more about yourself. And it's really encouraging. And I'm glad that not only that she likes it, but by the spread, by the word of mouth, she got her friends reading it. And I think it's a great time in our culture to have these books around to really, instead of having the parents tell you what's right and wrong or, you know, to do this a certain way, they can find it out in themselves. And it's a great kind of resource.
Jackson, what do you think, your character gets to really explore a lot of your backstory in this movie and sort of everything you went through. And I think the interesting thing about this is you talk about family is, you know, as Carlisle sort of creates this family, in some way chooses them, which, you know, you don't get to do in real life, your family, but your family you kind of do. What do you get to find out about Jasper? And then if you could all speak to sort of the familial aspect that the Cullens all have in common. Mm-hmm.
Well, it was exciting to get the chance to play Jasper's backstory. You know, getting to wear the Civil War regalia and riding the horse, and you know, the first scene we filmed, filming Eclipse, was myself as a human, you know, and getting changed into a vampire. So that was exciting in and of itself. Just, you know, being played a vampire for the first two films, finally get to show myself as a human. And, yeah, it's because I think Alice and Jasper are the only Cullen family members that weren't directly or indirectly turned by Carlisle per se. And so it's interesting whenever, like, they come together, and you know, Alice really saves Jasper from his old life, and she sees a vision of this family kind of forming, and you know, she brings us over there.
Now that you guys have this sort of crazy phenomenon and this fame that is sort of really out of control, do you have a lot of crazy stories where you have to, like, run out the back elevator and, you know, scoot out? And I mean, has that become now a way of life, or do you kind of go in and out of that world?
I think during filming, it kind of became like a game, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, to, like, figure out the back way out, you know, to... you know, figure out where we can go, like,
we could, like, split up and then all meet together. We'd never go somewhere together.
Just to avoid the paparazzis and everything.
So I love wearing wigs and Jackson mustaches. It's fun to.
Do you guys do that? Do you go out, like, and totally, like, dress up so that you can not be in?
Sometimes. Yeah.
It's because of the paparazzi, but really we just, like,
we enjoy it.
It's fun. It's fun.
An excuse for adult dress-up. what do you think is sort of new and different, or what is it about Eclipse that, you know, takes the story to the next level? What would you tell people is sort of the reason to go see Eclipse